has recognized the competence and strength of our university, the IIS University, and has placed it among the 38 deemed to be university of the country under category A. So Ministry of Human Resource Development ne deemed universities ki teen categories banaye, usme jo top category hai usme IIS University place hai. This is the list of the universities, and now let me take you to the history of this university. We started as an international college for girls in the year 1995, and since then there has been a phenomenal growth. We became a PG college in 1999, and then we were accredited A+ by NAC UGC in 2005. Then we were recognized as a model college by the state government, and granted autonomous status by the University Grants Commission in the year 2007. Thereafter, we were recognized as a college for potential for excellence in the year 2009. And after that, we were conferred a deemed to be university status under category A by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. We started functioning as a full-fledged deemed university in the year 2010, though we got the accreditation in the year 2009. Now, very often this question comes to anybody's mind that what is a deemed university and what are the benefits? Hum deemed university mein kyun jaye? Kya benefits hain? These are some of the benefits here. That we have the flexibility, we can introduce new programs, we can introduce and customize the syllabus according to the requirements of the time. So we can introduce new programs and courses. We regularly revise our syllabi and update it. हमें लगता है कि कुछ पोर्शन सिलेबस का हमारे आजकल की इंडस्ट्री के हिसाब से सूटेड नहीं है तो हम उसको चेंज कर सकते हैं. वी डिजाइन न्यू करिकुलम, वी इंट्रोड्यूस रिफॉर्म्स रिलेटेड टू असेसमेंट एंड इवैल्यूएशन, वी प्रमोट ग्लोबल स्टैंडर्ड्स इन हायर एजुकेशन, वी एंश्योर टाइमली कंप्लीशन ऑफ द सिलेबस, एंड देयर इज अ ग्रेटर इंपेटस टू रिसर्च, व्हिच मेक्स अस डिफरेंट फ्रॉम एनी अदर स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी और द सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी. लेट्स मूव ऑन. Now, looking at the course structure, the UG level, we have a foundation course. We have elective papers, so the students must have selected three papers that form the syllabus. There is one activity that the student has to choose out of these four that are offered. I'm going to talk more about that. And then there is career-oriented and skill development course. The idea is that along with the pursuance of a degree that the student is pursuing in the university, she can also have some other certificate, advanced or the advanced diploma degrees along with that. So this is the benefit here. Let me talk about assessment and evaluation. How does the examination and how does the function of assessment work here? It is twofold. The student has continuous assessment and semester end. These are the two type of tests of the exams the student has to take. कंटिन्यूस असेसमेंट मीन्स साल भर या छः महीने में जो भी बच्चा वर्क कर रहा है हम उसको मॉनिटर करते हैं, और इन हाउस टेस्ट्स हैं, जैसे एक क्लास टेस्ट है 15 मार्क्स का, मैं इसको और आगे बताऊंगी. सो द सी टेस्ट विच इज द कंटिन्यूस असेसमेंट विच इज टोटली इंटरनल इज 30%, एंड द सेमेस्टर एंड एग्जाम व्हेन द स्टूडेंट्स राइट देयर सेमेस्टर एंड एग्जाम इट्स नॉट आउट ऑफ 100, इट्स आउट ऑफ 70 मार्क्स, बिकॉज 30 मार्क्स दे ऑलरेडी स्कोर्ड. So in all, it comes to 100%. Let's look at the next slide. Well, this is continuous assessment and the semester end. Let me talk about the continuous assessment. As I said that this is spread out throughout the semester. The student is required to write just one class test. Now this one class test is of 15 marks only, and it's not an additional burden because only two units of the syllabus are covered in it. So two units, अगर बच्चा class में attentive है, अच्छे से क्लास अटेंड करता है, इट्स अ वेरी स्मॉल टेस्ट, देयर इज नो बर्डन ऑन एग्जाम एज सच ऑन द स्टूडेंट, एंड इट इज ऑफ 15 मार्क्स. नाउ दिस 15 मार्क्स इज वेरी वैल्यूएबल बिकॉज इट एड्स ऑन टू द मेन रिजल्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट. द अटेंडेंस, इफ द स्टूडेंट इज वेरी रेगुलर इन अटेंडिंग द कॉलेज, देन शी कैन स्कोर 5 मार्क्स. 90% एंड मोर अटेंडेंस गिव्स हर 5 मार्क्स. देन वी हैव द होम असाइनमेंट्स, द टीचर्स गिव होम असाइनमेंट, जस्ट वन होम असाइनमेंट इन द होल सेमेस्टर. And then again, you can consult the books and write a very nice answer to be able to get 5 on 5. So 5 marks can be very easily scored in the home assignments or the quiz. Then we have a classroom activity based on the performance of the student all through the semester in the class. This activity is scheduled, and then marks are accordingly awarded. And lastly, it works out to a total of 30 marks. So in case a student is regular, sincere, diligent, मन लगा के अगर वो क्लास में आता है, अटेंड करता है, तो ये 30 marks तो कहीं भी नहीं गए. So this is really internal and is in the hands of your board to secure very easily. Then we come to the semester exam, which is what the exam that is held at the end of every semester, which is of 70 marks, purely theoretical, and as well as there is practical paper that you may get to know later. But the theory paper is of 70 marks, and out of those 70 marks you can score. So at the end of it, these 70 marks plus the 30 internal assessment are joined together to finally bring out the result. When it comes to activities, we have a plethora of them here, and we ensure the students, please at your level, ensure your ward to come and attend them, because already the student may have selected one of the activity to be on, as a part of the curriculum. Now these are cultural activities, NSS, NCC and sports. चारों में से कुछ एक ना एक आपके ward ने पहले ही opt कर लिया है. आप उसको कहिए कि इसको ढंग से अटेंड करें, बिकॉज इट्स नॉट अ बर्डन एट ऑल अगेन. बिकॉज इसकी क्लास एक क्लास होती है मंडे को, फर्स्ट क्लास 9:30 to 10:30 एवरी मंडे विल बी अ एक्टिविटी क्लास वेयर द स्टूडेंट कैन गो पार्टिसिपेट एंड अर्न क्रेडिट. सो एट द एंड ऑफ दैट द स्टूडेंट अर्न्स 2 क्रेडिट फ्रॉम दैट. सो दीज आर अ पार्ट ऑफ द करिकुलम एंड पार्टिसिपेशन हेल्प्स अर्न द क्रेडिट. सो 2 क्रेडिट्स पर सेमेस्टर कैन बी अर्न by earnestly participating in these programs, and which further enhances the personality of the student. Talking about the extra co-curricular activities, at the time of admission, you were given a prospectus and you were given a handbook. Agar aapko dhyan ho, to hari do kitabein aapko di gayi thi at the time of admission. Now those are very important documents, and all details about the programs that will be held throughout the year are all mentioned there. So this is actually taken up from there, and you have more details with the date on in the academic calendar. उसको आप बहुत ध्यान से रखिए, क्योंकि आपको उसमें हर तरह की dates और events कब होने वाला है, वो सब details हमने निजाम के रखा है. So cultural activity, NSS, sports, कब freshers day होने वाला है, कब thank you party होने वाला है, ये सब date पहले से decided है, जो कि उसमें लिखी है. तो आप acquainted रहेंगे तो अच्छा रहेगा. The annual events are orientation program, जैसे कि आज होने वाला है. आप लोग के बाद में there'll be a very very detailed session that will be held until 1 o'clock. The student will be made to grasp the nitty-gritties of how the university functions. You know, talking about the infrastructure, about the systems, evaluations and everything. So we thoroughly give knowledge to the students, because knowledge is power. अगर हमें सब कुछ पता है तो हम आगे बढ़ पाएंगे. इसको ध्यान रखते हुए ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है. इसके अलावा फ्रेशर्स डे, थैंक यू पार्टी, देन वी हैव एनुअल फंक्शन दैट इज हेल्ड वंस इन अ ईयर फॉर अवार्ड गिविंग. देन आफ्टर वी हैव फेयरवेल प्रोग्राम, फेयरवेल सेरेमनी, एलुमनाई मीट, एनुअल प्ले, अ फेस्ट, अ 3-day फेस्ट कॉल्ड द IISU फेस्ट, एंड देन ऑल इंडिया IISU इंग्लिश डिबेट. दीज आर सम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम्स दैट आर ऑल्सो देयर इन द हैंडबुक. बिसाइड्स दैट वी हैव नंबर ऑफ गिल्ड्स, फोरम्स, सोसाइटीज एंड क्लब्स. Apart from the 4 activities that I have talked about, there are other avenues also open for the student to participate and hone her talents. So these are some of them: finance guild, cultural activity guild. She can enroll for any of these guilds and further hone her talents. So things such as home management, textile, fashion designing, eco-friendly association, chemical association, commerce club, computer science club, debating club, red ribbon club. ये बहुत सारे ऐसे छोटे clubs हैं on campus जिसमें कि बच्चे अपने आप को enroll कर सकते हैं और अपना best दे सकते हैं. Personality grooming is also an integral part of that. We also are a part of Speak Metri. So we have a chapter of Speak Metri on campus. And आप वाकई होंगे कि Speak Metri एक पुराना हमारा classical music को बचाने का एक प्रयास एक NGO के फॉर्म में, और जो बड़े बड़े एक्सपोनेंट्स हैं अलग अलग घरानों के, उनको बुलाया जाता है और वो बच्चों के साथ में एक डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन और परफॉर्मेंस देते हैं. सो दैट वी हैव हियर. देन वी हैव नंबर ऑफ इंटर यूनिवर्सिटी इवेंट्स ऑन डिफरेंट लेवल्स फॉर सच एज स्पोर्ट्स एंड कल्चरल एंड एकेडमिक. सो वी सेंड टीम्स टू डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटीज टू पार्टिसिपेट, वेदर दैट बी स्पोर्ट्स और दैट बी कल्चर और ऑल्सो एकेडमिक. सो टू अटेंड वर्कशॉप्स एंड conferences, etc. We have a very active sports department, we offer basketball, volleyball, table tennis, chess, cricket, and swimming, etc. and the coaching for these are available all through the year. So I encourage you all to go and meet up with the sports director and find out about when the coaching commences and register for that. So in case you think that your child has a flair for sports, definitely encourage her. कहिए कि जाके sports director से contact में रहे और aware रहे कि कब coaching शुरू हो रही है ताकि आप miss न कर जाए. Eventually, I come to conferences, seminars, workshops. These are all organized at the departmental level. So further, I encourage your ward to be a part of that so that she can write papers and she can present papers and she can be very, very actively involved in these departmental activities. And these are some things that are beyond the textbooks, beyond the curriculum, that will further enhance the personality of your ward. Now, we have certain student support initiatives. For example, we have this Earn While You Learn scheme, जिसमें कि हम लोग एक मौका देते हैं कि बच्चों को they can take up some kind of part-time assignments and yet have that little pocket money earned out of their endeavors. So they can take up any part-time assignments or job on campus. But the scheme works beyond the college hours. So the college gets over at 3:15. Thereafter, the college is open till 5. So the students can enroll for these, and then they can earn little pocket money out of that. The sections of the departments that assign these odd jobs are library, it could be placement, sales, website, etc. We also have preparatory classes. We try to offer everything that, so that the student doesn't have to go anywhere. So the preparatory classes are held for giving coachings and preparation for competitive examinations such as CAT, NET or civil services also, and our students are doing extremely well. They qualified for the RAS, and one of our students has very recently qualified for IAS prelims also. So our students are doing very well. So in case you think that you want to encourage you, I mean you want that your students should also register for this, this can also be done because these classes are held beyond the classroom hours. So if the college gets over at 3:50, the classes start at 3:30 or so and continue until 5:30. So the trend these days is that students register for these classes and along with their graduation, they are, for 3 years they prepare, and at the end of 3 years when they appear for these civil services, they are ready to take on. We also have a provision for remedial and tutorial and revision classes for students who were unable to attend the classes because of certain reasons, like कुछ medical sickness है, कोई sick leave, medical leave है, या फिर कोई academically challenged बच्चा है, उसको नहीं समझ में अगर आ पा रहा कुछ चीज़, या फिर कोई 50% attendance नहीं भी है किसी के पास, तो ऐसे बच्चे अगर है कोई, तो वो इन remedial classes में, इन tutorials में जाके और अपना understanding को बढ़ा सकते हैं, subject की foundation को पकड़ को मजबूत कर सकते हैं. और ये जो क्लासेस हैं ये हर डिपार्टमेंट में ऑर्गेनाइज की जाती हैं. द स्टूडेंट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू गेट इन टच विद द डिपार्टमेंटल हेड्स बिकॉज द डिपार्टमेंटल हेड्स ओनली अनाउंस अबाउट दीज क्लासेस. सो व्हेन दे आर हियर द स्टूडेंट्स कैन गो एंड दे कैन एनहांस देयर नॉलेज बेस. वी हैव अनदर वेरी फैंटास्टिक सिस्टम ऑन कैंपस. दिस इज कॉल्ड द मेंटोरिंग सपोर्ट. The system functions as though, as you know, we have a faculty member who is a mentor on campus, whose name is found in the fee slip. So when you you know submitted the fees for this award, उस वक्त आपको एक जो fee slip मिली उसके ऊपर एक faculty member का नाम मिला होगा. आप अगर देखिए गौर से तो वो आपके ward का mentor guardian है. 3 साल के लिए वो ही मेंटर गार्डन है. स्टूडेंट उनके साथ में अच्छा कांटेक्ट बना के रख सकता है और अपनी जो भी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं ऑन कैंपस, वेदर दैट्स रिलेटेड टू सिलेबस, वेदर दैट्स रिलेटेड टू क्लासेस, सो शी कैन गो अप्रोच हर मेंटर गार्डन एंड एनहांस एंड गेट हर प्रॉब्लम्स सॉल्व्ड और एनहांस हर नॉलेज और अंडरस्टैंडिंग और व्हाटएवर इश्यूज दैट शी माइट हैव. So the mentor guardian provides support to all the mentees' academic progress and overall development on campus. And encourage, so I request you all to kindly encourage your ward to stay in touch with her mentor guardian. These are some kind of meetings that are officially also announced, but at the same time, unofficially also, the student can stay in touch with the mentor guardian and get any kind of problem that she might have on campus, because the parents are far away. They may not be able to solve all the problems all the time. So sometimes the students can approach them and get their problems redressed. We also have a very active placement cell, and there's a regular counseling about various academic and competitive programs in case the student wants to find out ki kaun sa exam kab hone wala hai, hum aage kaise bar sakte hain. Ye sabhi kuch informations jo hai ye placement cell mein available hai. Ye nodal center hai for employment and deployment. Summer trainings, internships and interview, campus interviews are organized by them. They also provide some kind of trainings for campus interviews also. Companies are invited by the placement cell, which come and conduct campus drives here. So again, I request you, encourage your ward to register with the placement cell and stay in touch with the placement officer, because whenever there's a company arriving on campus, she can give them the information and they can be part of that placement drive. So these are some of the companies that have been here. IBM, TCS, some of the national and international stage of companies such as the Deutsche Bank, we have Barclays, we have some Indigo Airlines, and a lot of these, American, Bank of America. These are some of the companies. Apart from that, some of these are very well known companies that often visit our campus. Now, coming to attendance, now, this is a very, very vital issue. And 75% attendance is mandatory. So please encourage your ward to take the classes very seriously, attend the classes. And apart from this mandatory component, attendance will also help her get marks. As I told you, if the attendance is 90% and more, she gets 5 marks. So we want to make a good problem for the children to score marks. They may not be allowed to appear at the semester end exam in case of shortage of attendance. Attendance is a part of the continuous assessment and students shall be awarded marks for it. I've already talked about that. And attendance of the ward can be accessed through her MetaCampus account. May I be on MetaCampus ke baare mein aapko bata di. We have a biometric attendance system. Now in today's world, every one of us are really cautious about the children, where do they move, what do they do. Basically, why we organize this program is to make you aware about the functioning of the university. Aapko pata rahe ki university mein kab kya program hone wala hai, kaise program hone wala hai, taki aap empowered rahe aur apne student ko guide kar sake, apne board ko guide kar sake aur wo aapko buddhu na bana paaye. आजकल हम लोग कई बार देखते हैं कि स्टूडेंट्स बच्चे हैं, वो अपने पेरेंट्स को कुछ कह के आते हैं और करते कुछ और हैं. आप और हम एक ही लेवल पे हैं. इसको ध्यान में रखते हुए कई सारे सिस्टम्स सिक्योरिटी के हिसाब से भी बनाए गए हैं. बायोमेट्रिक सिस्टम उसमें से एक है. इसमें स्टूडेंट को कॉलेज में आप देखेंगे कि उसको अभी आई कार्ड इशू होगा बहुत जल्दी, और उस आई कार्ड को यूज़ करके बायोमेट्रिक अटेंडेंस से जुड़ा हुआ है वो, कि जैसे ही बच्चा कैंपस में आता है वो बायोमेट्रिक मशीन हमारे कैंपस में 5-6 जगह लगी हुई है, तो बच्चे को आते ही अपने कार्ड से बायोमेट्रिक अटेंडेंस में यू शो द कार्ड टू द बायोमेट्रिक मशीन एंड इट रजिस्टर्स द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द स्टूडेंट ऑन कैंपस. उससे जैसे ही वो रजिस्टर करता है आपको मैसेज आ जाएगा कि आपका बच्चा 9:15 पे 9:30 पे कैंपस में आ चुका है. इसी तरह से जब वो कैंपस से निकलता है बच्चा, तो वो वापस बायोमेट्रिक मशीन पर अपना कार्ड दिखाएगा, पंच करेगा, और आपको वापस मैसेज आ जाएगा उसका कि आपका बच्चा समय से इस समय पे कॉलेज से निकल गया है. नाउ दिस इज टू ट्रैक द मूवमेंट ऑफ योर स्टूडेंट, नॉट दैट इन एनी नेगेटिव सेंस आई एम सेइंग दैट, बट जस्ट टू इंश्योर द सेफ्टी ऑफ योर स्टूडेंट. यू शुड बी वेरी वेल अवेयर दैट आपका बच्चा कितनी बजे कैंपस में आया और कितनी बजे यहाँ से निकल गया, ताकि आप लोग भी संतुष्ट रहें और सिक्योर भी रहें कि द चाइल्ड इज मूव्ड आउट वेरी सेफली एंड इज नाउ अप्रोचिंग होम. Now this is what we had in mind. So this SMS to parents about the movement is gone. Now the one thing that we feel is that please ensure कि जो आपने मोबाइल दिया है वो आप ही का है. कई बार बच्चे बदमाश होते हैं, वो लोग अपना खुद का नंबर दे देते हैं, तो फिर क्या होता है मैसेज उन्हीं को जाता रहता है, आपको पता भी नहीं रहेगा कि ये मैसेज आपका बच्चा कब आया, मूवमेंट क्या है स्टूडेंट का. So please ensure that your numbers were given, the parents' numbers were given there and not the boards. Non-compliance shall be treated. Now, there's another benefit of this kind of biometric attendance, that student gets 2 credits for on-campus presence, right? So, if please encourage her to use this biometric attendance and do the needful 2 times in the day. That will also help her get credits. We have a very, very good transportation system. Our buses move to every nook and corner of the city. It moves in the morning, and we have both morning and noon sessions. And for that, eye cards are necessary. जो आई कार्ड मिलने वाला है वो बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है, आप अपने वार्ड को कहिए वो बहुत ध्यान से रखें, क्योंकि उसी से लाइब्रेरी की बुक्स इश्यू होती है, उसी से लैब में एंट्रेंस मिलती है, उसी से बस में चढ़ने को ड्राइवर हर बार चेक करते रहेंगे, उसी से हम लोग क्लासेस में भी चेक करते हैं कि बच्चा आई कार्ड पहन के आया है कि नहीं आया है. सो दिस इज़ रियली इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो आई कार्ड शुड बी कैरिड बाई द स्टूडेंट फॉर बोर्डिंग द बसेस. नो बस फैसिलिटीज अवेलेबल ड्यूरिंग द सेमेस्टर एंड एग्जाम. एग्जाम के टाइम पे, क्योंकि एग्जाम का अलग अलग टाइमिंग्स हो सकता है, तो हम लोग मॉर्निंग एंड इवनिंग पे एक ही टाइम पे चलाते हैं बस. तो ये फैसिलिटी उस टाइम पे नहीं पॉसिबल हो पाती. द स्टूडेंट विल नॉट बी अलाउड टू गेट डाउन द बस एट एनी पॉइंट अदर देन हर ओन विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ द पेरेंट, विच इज वेरीफाइड बाय द रजिस्ट्रार. अगेन अ सिक्योरिटी दैट वी ट्राई टू बी वेरी वेरी यू नो प्रोवाइड यू विद द बेस्ट काइंड ऑफ सिक्योरिटीज, दैट जो स्टॉप है बच्चे का चढ़ने का ड्राइवर वहीं ला के उतारेगा. उसके बियॉन्ड अगर वो कहता है कि मुझे अजमेर रोड की जगह मुझे विद्युत नगर उतार दे, ड्राइवर नहीं उतारेगा. अनलेस आप लिख के देंगे एप्लीकेशन और उसको अगर रजिस्ट्रार साइन कर दिए तभी ऐसा हो पाएगा, अदरवाइज बच्चे को कहीं भी नहीं उतार सकता ड्राइवर. दिस इज द सिस्टम दैट वर्क्स हियर. वी हैव अ वेरी गुड सिस्टम ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट विद पेरेंट्स बिकॉज वी बिलीव दैट बोथ ऑफ अस आर वर्किंग फॉर द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. So, regular intimation is given to parents about the student's performance and attendance. Every student and parent is issued with a password and a username for their MetaCampus account. So, at the time of admission, आपको भी एक password और username मिला होगा और student को भी मिला है. तो आप दोनों अपने अपने level से अपने अपने password से MetaCampus account को access कर सकते हैं और देख सकते हैं कि क्या हो रहा है. मैं अभी MetaCampus के बारे में और details में बताऊँगी. All important information related to the university can also be seen on the university website. The website address is here. It's also there on in the academic handbook, the prospectus, everywhere. Rules and regulations regarding examinations, curricula, credit templates, they're all available in the academic handbook. Moti kitab jo hai usme aap ye sab pa sakte. You could track the progress of your ward by seeking an appointment with the subject teacher. आप college में आके teacher से मिल सकते हैं, आप mentor guardian से मिल सकते हैं, आप उनके साथ में meta campus से contact रख सकते हैं. बहुत सारे avenues हैं जिससे आप अपने college में जो professors हैं उनके साथ में connected रह सकते हैं और ensure कर सकते हैं कि आपका ward जो है वो सही दिशा में जा रहा है, progress कर रहा है. Your queries can also be emailed at this address, which is again reflected in so many ways in different in the academic handbook, in the prospectus, on the fee slip, and everywhere. This is our home page. When you come to our website, this is our home page, and a lot of information can be got even by coming to this page. Now, let me talk about MetaCampus. This is a very unique feature that we have with us. Again, to track the students' movement, to ensure the safety and security of your ward, and to see that you are able to see the progress of your ward and to know exactly what's really happening on campus. This is the e-support system for both parents and students, an online platform for information of all types which can be accessed anytime, 24/7, 365 days a week. Sunday ko bhi aap access kar sakte hain isko, aap sahi se dekh sakte hain. Monitoring of students' performance in academics. It helps the parents and teachers meeting. It provides tangible data for measuring and analyzing the performance of your ward. An update of university activities also can be seen without you being on campus. You can see exactly what's happening on campus. This is our logging to MetaCampus. You know, you can go put in your username and your password and you can log into the MetaCampus. It's a unique account that has been created for all students as well as the parents. And the login details, the username, password has already been given to you in the pink fee slip that you got. So just check into that and log into this and see what really is happening here and be empowered. Now this is the MetaCampus account page for the parents, so you can also access it. We have permissions for both students and parents, so this is the page. You can also give us some kind of feedback. Any kind of feedback you want to give to the university, please feel free, because this has an option for the feedback also. All important notifications, notices, everything is sent on the MetaCampus. You can access it and find out what it is. Another such kind of page is there for the students. Students can also do everything. You can even pay up your fees. The students can pay the fees. They can apply for readmission. They can also put up any kind of grievances that they have. Right? So all kind of information, notifications, the heads of the department do send their notifications to the students. They post their home assignments on this campus. So it's a very useful device. How can you do that? You can download this app on your Android phone. When you go to IIS app, then you can come to the third one that is here, this emblem of ours. And then you can install it on your phone and be upgraded with all everything that's happening here. For the users of iPhone, we have a... Maybe you want to the next page, please. Yeah, for the people who use iPhone, then you can go to iTunes and you can download this. Now, how is this biometric system useful for the parents? Because you can track the progress of your ward. You can submit your readmission form, you can pay online fees, you can view assignments, announcements, and what are the events that are coming up. Class schedule, timetable, attendance, curriculum, exam schedule, you can get all information about the functioning of the university, you can interact with the faculty and the mentor guardians, and you can also see the faculty profile on this app. So this is very useful for the parents. Similarly, it's very useful for the students. They can look at their home assignments, announcements, forthcoming events, kya hone wala hai, kya event aane wala hai, ye sab kuch information mil sakte. Class schedule, timetable, attendance, online attendance fee. हम लोग अटेंडेंस लेके फिर मेरे कैंपस पे डाल देते हैं. आप लोग उसको देख सकते हैं कि आज आपका बच्चा क्लास में गया था कि नहीं गया था. आपने तो बस में बिठा के रवाना किया घर से, लेकिन कैंपस में आने के बाद वो क्लास में गया कि नहीं गया. Now that is on the student. So you can trace that out whether she went for the class that day or not. You can even do that. At the same time, you can view the performance and result paper wise of your ward and submit the readmission forms and pay the bill. So this is for the students as well as for the parents. The functions remain the same. Now, ragging is something that really terrifies the parents, you know, when the student comes to the university for the first time. But here, we ensure that no ragging takes place. It's an offense strictly banned here, and it may lead to suspension, rustication, and even expulsion of the student from the campus, from the university. अगर आपको कोई भी महसूस होता है कि आपका वार्ड किसी भी तरह से रैगिंग फेस कर रहा है, तो प्लीज़ फील फ्री. ये नंबर आपको प्रोस्पेक्टस में भी मिल जाएगा, हैंडबुक में भी है. हमारी एंटी रैगिंग स्क्वाड की हेड है डॉक्टर रेनू शुंगलू, या फिर रजिस्ट्रार को भी आप इन्फॉर्म कर सकते हैं इमीजिएटली, एंड यू कैन बी श्योर दैट एक्शन विल बी टेकन अगेंस्ट दैट. सो देयर इज नो रैगिंग ऑन कैंपस, इट्स एब्सोल्युटली बैड. लास्टली मैं इस बात पे आते हैं कि जनरली पेरेंट्स जो हैं वो एक क्वेरी लेके आते हैं और लेके वापस चले जाते हैं कि हमने डीम्ड यूनिवर्सिटी में अपने बच्चे को डाल दिया, अभी आगे क्या होगा, क्या ये यूनिवर्सिटी आगे जॉब्स दिलवा पाएगी, क्या इसकी रिकग्निशन है. ये सब तरह के क्वेश्चन जनरली पेरेंट्स के दिमाग में होते हैं. तो मैं ये आपको बता देना चाहती हूँ यहाँ पे कि दिस इज डेफिनेटली रिकग्नाइज बाय द यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट्स कमीशन. And our graduates are eligible to seek admission for higher studies wherever they go. So ऐसा नहीं है कि यहाँ से पढ़ने के बाद बच्चे को कहीं और, हर जगह जैसे और यूनिवर्सिटी में बच्चे पढ़ते हैं वैसे यहाँ पे पढ़ सकते हैं, पढ़ते हैं. And they can get admission in any university all over the country. At the same time, this degree is recognized for seeking jobs all over the country. Even if you go out, your credits can get transferred. If you go abroad, your credits can get transferred, and you can even benefit out of that. So have this very, very clear in your mind that coming to a deemed university is as good as going to any other university in the country. Here is a reiteration of something that I've already talked about. बस थोड़ा सा एक रीकैप की तरह हम इसको देख लें कि यहाँ पे हम लोग मोबाइल फोन्स आर स्ट्रिक्टली प्रोहिबिटेड ऑन कैंपस, स्पेशली इन द क्लासरूम. अगर कोई क्लास ले रहा है बीच में फोन बज जाता है तो वी विल नॉट अलाउ द स्टूडेंट टू टेक द फोन आउट एंड अटेंड ऑन द कॉल, वी विल सीज द फोन इमीडिएटली. सिमिलरली वी डू नॉट एनकरेज स्टूडेंट्स टू यूज द फोन ऑन कैंपस. डेफिनेटली इसी के साथ क्वेश्चन आएगा कि आज के समय में मोबाइल फोन बच्चे के पास ना हो तो क्या होता है, सबके पास है, बट आस्क देम टू कीप इट इन देयर बैग फॉर सेफ्टी सिक्योरिटी रीजंस, बट नॉट यूज इट ओनली व्हेन इट इज एब्सोल्युटली नेसेसरी. The students must wear decent clothes. जो professional course के बच्चे हैं उन लोग के लिए एक defined dress code है, so they should follow that. The students must wear their eye cards all the time while they are on campus. I've told you it's a very very important thing. और अगर आपके वार्ड का आई कार्ड खो जाता है तो इमीजिएटली आप एप्लीकेशन देके उसको फ्रीज कराइए, क्योंकि उसी आई कार्ड के आधार पे लाइब्रेरी बुक्स इश्यू होती है, नहीं तो कोई मिसयूज कर सकता है उसको. तो अगर ऐसा कभी होता है कि आई कार्ड खो गया है, आप इमीजिएटली उसको फ्रीज कराइए और नोटिफाई कराइए और उसको बहुत ही संभाल के रखिए, क्योंकि उसी से एंट्री है हर जगह. इवन कॉलेज में एंट्री आई कार्ड से ही, अगर आई कार्ड नहीं है तो बच्चा कॉलेज में घुस भी नहीं सकता. सो इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू द स्टूडेंट. Encourage your ward to register her attendance on the biometric machine twice on entry and on exit from the university. This is very useful for you, equally for the student also. Students must be counseled to attend the classes regularly. आप कहिए कि वो class attend करें. As I said, you put the child in the bus and sent from your home. But please also encourage her, because this kind of encouragement at the college level comes from the student themselves. We definitely at our level will go and push them, go attend the classes, but if they don't want to attend the classes, well, it's their loss. So please encourage your student ki college gaye to class attend karke aaye, aur bahar baat karke aa gaye to attendance nahi milegi, aapko lagega ki aapka bachcha college ja raha hai, par kya problem hai, problem ye ki class mein nahi ja raha. To aap log usko encourage kare ki jaye aur classes attend kare, kyunki school mein to school teacher le jaate hain, zabardasti bithai dete hain. हम लोग कॉलेज में ऐसा नहीं कर सकते हैं. कॉलेज में बच्चे के पास छूट है, वो आता है कॉलेज, लेकिन आप लोग कहेंगे, एनकरेज करेंगे, वी ऑल्सो एट आवर लेवल ट्राई आवर बेस्ट टू एनकरेज देम टू गो अटेंड द क्लासेस. सो इन केस दे डोंट डू दैट, इट्स अ लॉट ऑफ लॉस, यू मे हैव रियलाइज्ड बाय नाउ. दे मस्ट ऑल्सो कीप अ चेक, मस्ट चेक देयर मेट कैंपस अकाउंट ऑन अ रेगुलर बेसिस टू कीप देमसेल्व्स अपडेटेड फॉर द फॉरथकमिंग इवेंट्स. नाउ दैट गोज फॉर बोथ पेरेंट्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स. आप चेक करते रहिए, आपको भी पता रहेगा, स्टूडेंट को भी पता रहेगा कि क्या हो रहा है. Advise your ward to submit home assignments and project. As I told you, home assignments fetch 5 marks. So in case the कोई बात है कि हम ये नहीं explanation बच्चे से लेके, हमको पता नहीं था, क्योंकि सब चीज़ मेरे कैंपस पे पोस्टेड है, वर्बली बताई जा रही है, क्लास में बताई जा रही है. उसके बावजूद भी अगर कोई समय पे होम असाइनमेंट नहीं सबमिट करता है तो नुकसान बच्चे का है, क्योंकि उसको 5 में से 0 मिलने वाले हैं. Ensure that your ward takes the CA test seriously to avoid any academic loss. That's why I put this slide here, so that you realize that it's a 15 marks. It cannot be taken easily. 15 number ka CA test hai, usko agar bacche ne chhod diya, to jab tak wo clear nahi karega, wo test uska due chalta rahega. Ye test dena zaruri hai, to ye bacha usko de, kyunki ek baar agar routine se ye chhod gaya to fir ye due mein chalta rahega aur ye additional burden bacche ke liye ban jayega, kyunki aage isse aage badhta प्रोग्रेस तो होता रहेगा, लेकिन ये ड्यू में शो करता रहेगा. इट विल हैव टू बी क्लियर एट अंटिल द स्टूडेंट पासेस आउट द यूनिवर्सिटी. सो प्लीज इंश्योर दैट योर स्टूडेंट टेक्स अप दिस टेस्ट एंड डजंट फ्रिवोलसली गो अवे, यू नो, अनअटेंडेड, दैट आई विल नॉट टेक अप द टेस्ट. देयर विल बी लॉट्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर द स्टूडेंट एट द एंड ऑफ इट. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट वी थॉट दैट इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट एंड यू शुड नो वेरी वेल. In case there are any further queries that you might have beyond this, you can ask the queries if there are any. But my personal word of advice is, please go through the academic handbook that has been given to you and keep that handy with you all the time, because all schedules, all programs, even the activities are listed very clearly. In case your student has taken up cultural activity or NSS or sports, humne date wise bhi events dale hain ki aaj ke din mein kya program hone wala hai. तो आप लोग उसको अच्छे से पढ़िए और एम्पावर्ड रहिए. एंड लेट नॉट द चाइल्ड फूल यू अवे, एंड यू बी इक्वली एम्पावर्ड टू टैकल एंड टू टेक द चाइल्ड ऑन द रोड ऑफ प्रोग्रेस. सो इन केस देयर आर एनी इश्यूज और एनीथिंग दैट यू'ड लाइक टू नो, प्लीज फील फ्री टू आस्क. एंड इन केस देयर आर नो क्वेरीज, एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर पेशेंट लिसनिंग. I hope that this session has been very useful in understanding the mechanisms of the college and understanding the functioning of the college. And we equally ask you to support us in giving the best that this university can offer to your student. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. This is for the information of parents whose ward will be available.
to motivation and progress, from failures and setbacks to moving ahead and success. We will stand with you through all these things to watch you lead and fly with your strengthened wings. Namaskar. To each one of you, this day marks the beginning of the roller coaster ride called the university life. As you step into this new phase of your life, I, on behalf of the faculty and students,
I extend a very hearty welcome to all of you and thank you for reposing confidence in the IIS University. I welcome you to the learning community of the IIS crew, the journey of which started as a college in 1995. The college, that is the International College for Girls, was accredited A by the NEC or UGC and declared a model college with potential for excellence in 2005. It was granted an autonomous status by the University Grants Commission in 2007 and was conferred the status of a deemed to be university in 2009, and the review committee which decided about the grading of such deemed universities put this university amongst 38 such universities which fall under category 1, and the government of India declared it 3 years back. The college has been granted the 12B status for a greater autonomy in terms of applying for financial assistance for major research projects, etc. The university is a part of the IIS group of institutions, India International School, IIIM, that is International Institute of Management and Computer Science, ICT Institute of Education Research and Development, and is a place for a complete education being provided to nearly 5,000 students in undergraduate, postgraduate and research programs. Several new courses too have been introduced from this year onwards. We have also gone in for a choice-based credit system from this year to allow greater flexibility and choice to students. The university boasts of a buzzing campus life with extra and co-curricular activities, including NSS, NCC, games and sports, Rotary Club, theatrical society, guilds and associations. We have several national and international research tie-ups and linkages, including those with the industry and the corporate sector. We have our own research publications, such as journals, newsletters and magazines, a community radio station, Radio 7, health club, alumni association, and a training and placement center. The university prides itself on being a meta campus with several online features related to students' life on campus, particularly teaching learning, and can be accessed by parents as well. We have committees such as anti-ragging and anti-sexual harassment for a disciplined and hassle-free stay on the campus. The faculty members here make use of innovative learning methods for the best possible learning experience. We are also very proud of our well-placed alumni who are not only homemakers but also join IAS, Army, and working in top multinational companies and education institutions. We are thus moving towards transforming lives by making knowledge meet skills in a real-time learning environment. Hoping that you have a fruitful and pleasant learning experience here at the IIS University, I wish you all the best for all your academic endeavors, and I'm sure all of you would have a great experience being students of this university. Welcome once again.
We are distributing the feedback forms of the orientation session. Kindly fill it at the end of the session and hand it over to the volunteers before leaving the auditorium.
Once again. So tell me, are you happy?
Yes.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Yes.
Okay, right. So now you're going to embark on a very, very exciting phase of your life. 3 years of college life are going to be probably the best period of your life. But college is not just about freaking out with friends and, you know, having fun on campus, but that is a very integral part of college life, of course. But the primary purpose of being in college is academics. So that's what I'm going to talk to you about. The academics that you're going to have here, the curricula, the syllabi, would be different from what you've been used to at school level, right? So let's get acquainted. I will not go into details because we'll probably have more orientation sessions department-wise. So I'll just acquaint you with the technical terms, the jargon that we use here with respect to our studies. Alright, now let's start with the very first term which you have encountered again and again since you filled up the form of the university, that the IIS university is a deemed university. What is a deemed university? Do you have any idea? Anyone? Did you at any point of time feel that it's a deemed university? Are the degrees recognized? Will I be able to land a job for myself once I'm through with the course? Did you think about it? Do you have apprehensions about taking admissions in a deemed university? Well, let me tell you, a deemed university in India, we have four kinds of universities, all right? We have the central universities like JNU, Delhi University. We also have a central university here in Rajasthan, near Ajmer. Now, central universities come into existence by an act of the parliament. Alright? Then we have state universities. Like Rajasthan University is a state university. State universities come into existence by an act of state legislature. Alright? Then we have deemed universities, which are granted their status by Ministry of Human Resource Development, MHRD, Government of India. MHRD has been in news recently. Anyone, any idea why it has been in news very recently, 1-2 days back? Yes?
Minister has changed now.
Okay, who's the new minister now? Good. So this is a very aware lot that we have got this time. Yes. So we are recognized by MHRD on the recommendation of UGC. UGC is University Grants Commission, which is the apex body in the country to look into the nitty-gritty of higher education in India. Alright, so we have government recognition. Our students, degrees of our students are recognized all across the country and even abroad. Our students go and make admissions in universities abroad in India. They get employment, jobs, good professional profile on the basis of our degree. So rest assured, the degrees are very much in order, right? Now let's move on to something else. Now coming to the academics, can we start with the PPT? I'll skip the first few slides. because the first few slides document our history, but it has already been covered in the address by the Honorable Vice Chancellor, so I'll not dwell on it anymore. Can we have the next slide, please? Okay, if we can stop here. These are the last points which I think I'll begin my presentation based on these points. As a deemed university, our curricula has certain unique features. Alright? First, it is semester-based. I'll come to the term. Okay, it is semester-based. Then our syllabi are unitized. And third, we work on credit system. So these are three terms which you have, probably you may have heard about them, but you don't really know what they're about. So let's take up each of these one by one. I said our education system is based on semester scheme rather than annual scheme. Most of the universities in India are now switching to semester scheme. What is a semester scheme? In school you had an annual scheme. You took admission in the month, you moved into a new class, the new session began in July, it ended in March, right? So you probably studied for one whole year, that was your academic year. Here in the university now, your academic year will not be of one or the duration of 1 year, it will be of duration of 6 months. So in 1 year, you will have two semesters. Starting from July till December is the first semester, which is the odd semester. Then starting from December till April is the second semester, which is the even semester. Alright, so you have 3 years of degree course here, you are enrolled in 3 years degree course. So you will be studying for 6 semesters, right? Now a unique feature of these semesters is that these semesters are exclusive, mutually exclusive in the sense that once you give the exam of one semester, that semester is closed, alright? And what you have done in that particular semester will not be quizzed or asked again in the next semester. You may logically take the topic further in the next semester, but once you've given the semester end examination, for all technical purposes, that semester is over there, alright? So, why I am reiterating this point again and again, take your semester end exams very seriously because they are the final exams for that particular semester. Alright? Don't treat your semester end exams as midterm exams because they fall somewhere in November, December for odd semester. Don't think these are half yearly exams which we used to appear in school. So it's okay if we skip them. If you skip your semester end exam, you're actually skipping your final exam for that particular semester. Alright? So is the concept of semester clear to all of you? So you'll have to get used to working in a semester scheme. So you are studying concentratedly a few topics. Alright? And exams will be held for those at the end of the semester and we wrap up that semester there. Then you move to a new semester. Right? So that is what we mean by semester scheme. So for students who are enrolled in BA, BA Honours, BSc, BSc Honours, your 3 year program is actually made up of 6 semesters. Right? So okay, so this is semester out of the way. Then I said our syllabi are unit based. Right now I don't think any of you have had the access to the syllabi which you would be studying in your chosen courses. But for your information, our syllabi are all uploaded on our website. So you can access them. Alright? Access the syllabi with say syllabi for 2016-17. Alright? Now if you look at the syllabus of each paper that you have opted for, each paper will be made up of 5 units. Uniformly. Alright? So for instance, if you are enrolled in Economics Honours and you have 4 papers in Economics Honours in first semester, first paper of Economics Honours will be made up of 5 units. Alright? Second paper will also be made up of 5 units. So in one semester for each paper, we are covering 5 units and you will be quizzed on that at the end of the semester. Of course, there will be a CA exam test also in between. Dr. Nisha Yadav, the controller of examination, will talk to you about the examination and assessment part of the academics here. So that is what we mean by unit-based syllabi. Have you understood this? Okay, now let's come to the most technical part of my presentation today, which is credit system. Here at this university, as per the UGC mandate, we are working on credit system. Alright, now just to make it clearer to you, we have two sets of systems being followed right now. Ordinary credit system for students enrolled in BA, BA Honours, BSc, BSc Honours, BCom, BCom Honours, BBA. Alright, we just follow credit system for these people, students. But for professional courses like BBA, BCA, we have choice-based credit system. So I will not be talking about choice-based credit system to you people, because that's not the system you are following. You're following ordinary credit system, right? Now, what is a credit system? Next slide, please. Next, please. Okay, before I go to the credit system, let me tell you a little bit about, you are probably familiar with this because you must have by now gone through the academic handbook, but what is the package, academic package, not in terms of money, package in terms of papers and courses that we offer to you when you opt for a particular program, alright? Now, if you have opted for BA, BSc pass course, the package that comes your way will have foundation papers. In first semester, they would be English compulsory. Then you have to make choice. You have to opt for Hindi, French, or German as for second paper. All right, you are familiar with that. So you have, your package will have two papers of foundation, three electives from list of electives that you've already filled up. You know what electives you've opted for. For instance, if you are enrolled for BA pass course, electives that you may have opted for could be history, economics, psychology. Or if you have opted for BSc, one of the option could be biotechnology, botany, zoology. So the electives that you do will be three electives made up of three papers each. So in one semester, you are basically doing nine papers. Alright, and electives that you offer in the first year will stay with you throughout your stay. What do I mean by this? For instance, if you have opted for history, economic, psychology, you will study history, economic, psychology for 3 years. You can't switch to some other subject in the next semester. Alright, then besides foundation papers and elective papers, you will have to offer one activity, NSS, NCC, sports, cultural. Alright, it is compulsory to do at least one activity in the first two semesters. After that, it becomes optional. You will get detailed information about this in some other presentation during the course of the day. And then you will have to offer compulsorily one career-oriented and skill development course. This is, we call it COST. On campus, COSD courses are tiered. They are arranged in certain levels. The first level that you do in the first year is certificate course, right? And it is based on annual scheme, not on semester scheme. So you have to offer one certificate level course. Now this offers you a lot of horizontal mobility. You can offer for any COSD course. For instance, if you're enrolled for enrolled in science, a BSc, but you can opt in a COSD in photography or in music. It is not necessary that just because you enrolled for BSc, you have to opt for a science-based COSD course. So this sort of offers you a horizontal mobility. All right, let's. Similarly, for honors program, students enrolled in honors program, you have again two foundation papers. Then instead of three electives as the case is in pass course, you will have two electives. One elective is called the major. Major is what you have opted for as an honors subject. Say English honors is your major and psychology subsidiary is your subsidiary or minor. So you're doing two electives, and then again NSS, NCC, sports, cultural and career oriented and skill development course. Okay, that's the package that comes your way. Now let's move to credit system. What is credit system? Credit system is basically, can we have the next slide please? Next, please. Next. Okay. What do we mean by credits? Credits basically mean, these are units. Okay? And you have to earn them. Right? How do you earn units? How do you earn credits? Credits are assigned on the basis of amount of work that you have to do for each paper. For instance, like I told you, suppose you have opted for English Honours and Psychology subsidiary. Alright, so you have 4 papers of English Honours and 3 papers of Psychology subsidiary. In all, you are doing 7 papers as an Honours program student. Alright, now each of these 7 papers would carry certain credits and you have to earn those credits. How do you earn credits and what do we mean by credits? Credits would mean the amount of work that you are required to do in a particular paper. And what do we mean by amount of work to be done in a paper? Amount of work is specified in terms of attending classes, presenting seminars, submitting home assignments, okay, making presentations, doing field visits, doing practicals, so on and so forth. This is what we mean by amount of work. All right. Now, for instance, a particular paper carries 3 credits. You have to earn those 3 credits in order to get your results. Your results would be not in terms of percentages. Of course, I am not going to details of that because that would be dealt by Dr. Nisha Yadav in the next session. But your result and your promotion are intimately tied up with credits. Alright, so you have to earn certain amount of credits in order to be promoted, and you have to complete all credits required in a particular program in order to earn your degrees. Alright, now how do you earn credits? So you know that you have to do, my first paper in English Honours carries 3 credits. So I have to earn those. How do I earn those 3 credits? By clearing that paper, by passing that particular paper. Alright, and when I say passing or clearing that particular paper, I mean passing the internal component of that particular paper and external component of that particular paper. You are assessed and evaluated on the basis of internal evaluation as well as on the basis of external evaluation. Internal evaluation will include components like CA test, attendance, home assignments, classroom interaction. That will make 30% of your assessment. 70% of the assessment or evaluation comes from semester end examination. You have to pass in that particular paper both in CA as well as in semester end examination in order to earn 3 credits. Okay? And earning 3 credit is based on all or none phenomenon. If you clear that particular paper, you earn all the credits assigned to that particular paper. Credits are not tied to the marks that you have obtained in that particular paper. For instance, if somebody has got 60% in that particular paper and someone else has got 80%, both of them will earn 3 credits. So it's based on whether you are able to clear that particular paper or not. It is not tied to your marks. So the question is then, what are marks for? Are marks not important? Of course, marks are very, very important because ultimately your results will be in terms of credits and marks combined. The formula will be told to you in the next session. Okay? So you need to earn credits in order to complete that particular degree program. Now, what is the advantage of credits? Why do I need credits at all? A, I told you, your result will be in terms of credits. If you do not earn credits for a particular paper, you will be shown as not passed. Alright? And until you completely earn the credits of all papers included in the program, you will not get your degree. Alright? Secondly, when you go to other universities in India and abroad, You are assessed more on the basis of how many credits have you earned, more than your total percentage or marks. How many credits have you earned? So mobility across universities in India and abroad becomes easier if you are in a credit system, if you are in a system which follows credits. Alright, so basically we are putting our students at an international level. You can compete with other students if you have a complete record of these many credits I have earned in my UG program. Alright, so mobility across universities plus in order to enhance your result will be reported in terms of credits plus marks. Okay, third, a very important thing is your promotion is based on credits. You see, you need certain number of credits to be promoted to the next semester. So you need to be very serious about these credits. Alright, have you understood these? Does anyone have any query regarding credit system? Okay. Next, please. The formula of credits is like this. You do 1 hour of theory paper in a week, that equals to 1 credit. So in a particular semester, mostly the papers would be querying either 3 credits or 2 credits. Alright? Next, please. Now how do you earn credits? For example, in psychology, BA Bias Course psychology paper, you have two theory paper, 1 practical, total. Each theory paper will carry 3 credits in that particular semester, and practical will carry 2 credits. This comes to 8 credits. And if you have 3 such papers, 8 into 3 is 24 credits. So for past course students, 3 electives will equal to 24 credits. So in the first semester, you are required to earn 24 credits. Second semester, again, you are required to earn 24 credits, so on and so forth. Next, please. I think I'll right now at this particular point of time, this much information is enough food for thought for all of you. For more detailed information, you may read the academic handbook. Alright, and of course subsequent to this session, you will have sessions at department level also. So these concepts will be discussed again and again till you become familiar with them. But if you have any query at any point of time, you can contact me. I'm Dr. Rupa Mathur. Can we have the last slide, please? You can contact Dr. Rakhi Gupta. She is the registrar. You can contact the advisor, Dr. K. S. Sharma. You can contact me, Dr. Rupa Mathur, and controller of exam, Dr. Nisha Yadav. You have the academic handbook also. I'll advise you to go through that handbook. It's like the Bible for you for this particular, for the 3 years that you are here with us. Please read this academic handbook very, very carefully so that you do not end up making any mistakes and adversely impacting your career. Okay? Thank you so much. And if you have any query, do let me know. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Kindly note that this orientation session is for the students of BA Honours and Pass Course, BSc Honours and Pass Course, and BBA.